So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 24/7. I am Manish Mishra and guys, in today's session I will bring to you 5 more questions from the PIB news. This session is beneficial for various government exams, especially for ESI section of RBI Grade B. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, if you are new here, you can subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the session, or iska link aapko description mein mil jayega. Okay, so let's begin with the very first question, which says that on the National Education Day, which is on 11th of November, it is the birthday of Maulana Abul Kalam Azad. Maulana Abul Kalam Azad, he was the first education minister of our country. So on this day, IIT Bombay presented Research Excellence Awards in 3 categories. So the question is, which of the following are not the categories under the awards given? So IIT Bombay ne 3 awards diye the under the Research Excellence Awards. So we have to identify which of the following is not the categories under which the awards have been given. Okay. So guys, these are the 3 awards categories. Number 1 is Research Publication Award. Then we have Research Dissemination Award. Then we have Early Research Achiever Award. So these are the 3 awards. These are the 3 categories of awards that have been given by IIT Bombay on the National Education Day. That was the birthday of Maulana Abul Kalam Azad, who was the first education minister of our country. Okay. So this was this news guys. That's it. इसमें आपको इससे ज़्यादा नहीं पढ़ना, और ये award किस-किस को मिला है, that is not important for the exam because वो काफी ज़्यादा detailed data है. So that will not be asked in your exam. So let's move on to the question now. So the question is, which of the following are not the categories? So Research Publication Award is one of the category. Dissemination Award is the category. And Research Associate Award is not there. Research Excellence Award is not there. Early Research Achiever Award is there. So 3 and 4 are not the categories. So therefore the correct answer should be what? Option B, 3 and 4. And now let's move on to the question number 2, which is about the revised targets of the Pradhan Mantri Kusum Yojana. And Kusum stands for Kisan Urja Suraksha Evam Uthan Mahabhiyan. Okay. And if you want to know in detail about this PM Kusum Yojana, then you can watch the government scheme video. Okay, humne iske upar ek session kiya tha in the government scheme series, jo ki Saturday Sunday chalti hai. So in that series, you can watch the session of PM Kusum. So here the question is, consider the following statements regarding the PM Kusum and identify the correct statements. So we have to identify the correct statements regarding PM Kusum scheme. And remember one more thing, that PM Kusum was launched in the year 2017, that is very important. It was asked in exam once and can be asked in future also. Okay, so these are the guys revised target. Ministry of New and Renewable Energy ke under aata hai this scheme, and the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy is headed by Mr. R.K. Singh. His Lok Sabha constituency is Ara in Bihar. Okay, so this ministry has revised the targets of PM Kusum, and now the targets are: solar capacity production target has been increased to 30.8 gigawatt by the year 2022, while the financial support has also been increased to 34,035 crores. Okay, how much? 34,035 crores. Earlier it was 34,022 crores. So the financial support jo hai uske andar bhi thoda sa increase kiya hai. The increase is not that more, but yes, there is an increase. Earlier it was 34,022, but now it has been increased to 34,035. Okay, PM Kusum Yojana is for the providing solar production capacity to the farmers so that they can use solar pumps and thereby they can provide proper irrigation water, irrigation facility to their farms. Okay, and this is under the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, launched in the year 2017. And for more details about the scheme, you can watch the session under the government scheme series. Alright, so now let's come to the question. So we have to identify the correct statements. So Ministry of New and Renewable Energy has extended the solar capacity target to 30.8 gigawatt by 2022. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Financial support under PM Kusum has been revised to rupees 34,035 crore. This is again absolutely correct. And the scheme was launched in 2015. So this should be not there. The scheme was launched in 2015. No. Was it in 2015 guys? No guys, it was in 2017. So therefore this statement is incorrect, which means we have 2 statements correct here, which are option A, only 1 and 2. So therefore option A will be the correct answer here. And now let's move on to the question number 3, which is about Interstate Migration Policy Index 2019. Okay, so this index has been released. Let us first discuss about this index. So this guy's interest rate migrant policy index 2019 has been released by a non-profit organization which is known as India Migration Now. It is a Mumbai based NGO basically. So it provides data about the integration of migrants. Okay, जो migrants किसी state में जब जाते हैं तो उनके लिए वहां की state क्या करती है, कैसे कदम उठाती है उनके livelihood के लिए, उनके benefits के लिए, उसी index, उसी चीज को ये index बताता है. Okay, so this index tells us about the steps that have been taken by the respective states where migrants are moving. Okay, so this index measures the state's efforts for integration of interstate migrants. All right, and in this index there are 8 parameters. So these are the 8 parameters: child rights, education, health and sanitation, housing, identity and registration, labor markets, social benefits and political inclusion. So life ke har sphere ko include kiya gaya hai. So in this parameter all the spheres of the lives are included. And after mapping all these parameters, this index have been created by this non-profit organization. Okay, and talking about the scores, so India's average score for 28 states and Union Territory of Delhi. Okay, Union Territory of Delhi or 28 states ka mila ke jo average score hai, that is how much? 37. And Delhi, despite of lot of migrants here, has a very low score of 34. Delhi ka jo score hai, bahut zyada kam hai, 34. And these scores, guys, are out of 100. Okay, these scores are out of 100. So overall average jo hai hamare country ka, that is how much? 37. While Delhi score, despite of having lot of migrants, the score is very poor, 34. And the top of course is what? Kerala. Hamesha jo southern states hote hain wo hamesha index mein top rehte hain, guys. So Kerala is number 1 with a score of 57. Then we have Goa and Rajasthan with a score of 51 each. And these are the only 3 states which have got scores more than 50. Inke baad sorry, इसके बाद जितने भी स्टेट थे सबका जो स्कोर था that was less than 50. Okay, and the lowest score is of Manipur, that is 90. Okay, so this was about the score, and in these you have to remember the India's average score, that is 37. You have to remember the top scorer, that is Kerala, and you have to remember the bottom scorer, that is Manipur, and the score is 19, and only the 3 states that have scored more than 50. Okay, so that was about this news, and let's move on to the question now. Which of the following are the top 3 states in the Interstate Migration Policy Index 2019? So guys, the 3 states are Goa, Kerala and Rajasthan, which means 3, 4 and 5 will be the correct answer, option D. Alright, so option D will be the correct answer here, Goa, Kerala and Rajasthan. Kerala was at the number 1 with a score of 57, while Goa and Rajasthan were at the second or third position with a score of 51. Alright, while the Kerala score is 57. Alright. So now let's move on to the question number 4 and 5. So now guys, question number 4 and 5 are from the static portion, and these are based on the GI tags. Humne GI tags ka naam zarur suna hoga, geographical indication tag. So let us discuss about GI tag first, and then we'll do the question number 4 and 5. So first of all, what is a GI tag? GI stands for geographical indicator, right? So what is this GI tag? So it is, guys, a name. It is a name or a sign given to a certain product. किसी एक सर्टेन प्रोडक्ट को दिए जाने वाला नाम या फिर एक साइन है या फिर एक ट्रेडमार्क है दैट रिलेट टू अ स्पेसिफिक ज्योग्राफिकल लोकेशन और ओरिजिन्स लाइक अ रीजन, टाउन और अ कंट्री. सो ज्योग्राफिकल इंडिकेटर का मतलब यह है कि कोई ऐसा प्रोडक्ट दैट इज इंडिकेटिंग द ज्योग्राफिक ज्योग्राफिक फीचर्स ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर एरिया, राइट. सो कोई भी एक ऐसा प्रोडक्ट जो किसी एक पर्टिकुलर एरिया के बारे में बताता है, दैट इज नोन एज अ ज्योग्राफिकल इंडिकेटर, राइट. And in India, geographical indication tag is given through the geographical indications of goods registration and protection act of 1999. But remember, this act was enforced in the year 2003. The act was passed in the year 1999, but it was enforced in the year 2003. And remember the name of the act, guys, geographical indications of goods registration and protection act of 1999. And guys, this act is administered by the Office of Controller General of Patents, Design and Trademarks. Okay, Office of the Controller General of Patent, Design and Trademark is act ko administer karne ka kaam karta hai. And currently, the Controller General of Patent, Design and Trademark is Mr. O.P. Gupta. Okay, O.P. Gupta is the current Controller General of Patent, Design and Trademark, and it is headquartered in Mumbai. It is headquartered there in Mumbai, and Darjeeling Tea. Okay, Darjeeling Tea was the first product in our country to get the GI tag. GI tag milne wala, lene wala, pehla jo product tha hamare desh mein, wo kaun sa tha? Darjeeling tea, right? So, and now what are the benefits of the GI tag? So, there will be legal protection to the products. मतलब अगर कोई product है वो कहीं का geographical indicator है तो वो same product कहीं और का geographical indicator नहीं हो सकता. Then prevents unauthorized use of GI tag products by others. And it will also help consumers to get quality products of desired characteristic. अगर मेरे को if we see the Darjeeling, तो अगर मेरे को Darjeeling की चाय चाहिए तो मैं कहाँ जाऊंगा? Obviously Darjeeling जाऊंगा, वहां से वो टी ले लूंगा. Okay, so these are some benefits of GI tag and I hope you all are now clear with the GI. So GI को आपने क्या क्या चीजें याद रखनी है जो कि आपके लिए काफी इंपॉर्टेंट है. This, the name of this act, this act is administered by this organization. And who is the current Controller General of Patent Design and Trademark? Mr. O.P. Gupta. And which was the first product to get the GI tag? That is Darjeeling tea. Okay. So this was about this GI tag. Now let's move on to the question number 4. So consider the following statements regarding GI tags and Office of the Controller General of Patent Designs and Trademarks and identify the correct statement. So these are some statements about the GI tag and the Office of Controller General of Patent Design and Trademark. You have to identify the correct statements. So in India, geographical indications registration is administered by the Geographical Indication of Goods Registration and Protection Act of 1994. Okay, it was not 1994. It was 1999 when this act was passed. Okay, but it was enforced in the year 2003. Remember this also. Shri S.P. Sharma is the current Controller General of Patent Design and Trademark. So is that Shri S.P. Sharma? No guys, it is Mr. O.P. Gupta. Alright, O.P. Gupta, who is the current Controller General of Patent Design and Trademark. So this statement also is incorrect. Alright, and the first product in India to get GI tag was Zardalu Mango from Bihar. No, that was not Zardalu Mango. Of course, Zardalu Mango ko to pichle saal, I think 2018 mein mila tha. And Zardalu Mango ke saath saath Magahi Paan bhi hota hai, Magahi Paan. Wo bhi Bihar ka hai, usko bhi nahin se GI tag mila tha. Alright, so this statement is also incorrect, which means none is correct, should be the correct answer here, option D. Alright, and now the question number 5, that's very important question. These are the GI tags that have been recently given and these are the respective states kahan kahan pe diye gaye hain, and these are not the respective, you have to match with the respective states jahan jahan pe in products ko GI tag diye gaye hain. Matlab ye jo products hai kaun kaun se states ke hain jinko GI tag mila hai. These are all the very recent. I hope you will be able to solve this question, guys. So let me read out the name of products. First of all, we have Chindamangalam Sari, then we have Telia Rumal, we have Harmal Chili, we have Tezpur Lychee, we have Chak Hao. So let me tell you the answer now. So I hope you are now able to identify the answer. Chindamangalam Sari is from where? Kerala. Alright, so 1 is matching with S. Alright. Telia Rumal is from Telangana. Alright, so second is matching the T. Then we have Harmal Chili. Harmal Chili is from Goa, which means 3 stands for R. And Harmal Chili and also Khola Chili. There is one Khola Chili also, which have got GI tag from the Goa. Then we have Tezpur Lychee, that is very recent, that have got GI tag, that is from Assam. So 4 ka P. Okay, so Tezpur Lychee sabse recent hai, jisko bhi abhi recently GI tag mila hai. Then we have Chak Hao, which is a rice. Okay, Chak Hao is a rice from Manipur, which means 5 is matching with Q. So 1X, 2T, 3R, 4P and 5Q, which means option A will be the correct answer. Alright, option A will be the correct answer and I hope, and guys, this type of question aapke exam mein poocha ja sakta hai. And remember, jitne bhi GI tags jo ki aapke exam se at least 8 year ke hain, 1 year se pehle ki jitne bhi GI tags hai, wo aapko zarur pata hona chahiye, and that can be asked in your exam. Okay. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope the session is clear, and if you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Goodbye, take care and God bless.